Hello, my name is James, and today I'm going to show you how to take existing product data from a CSV file or an Excel file and translate that into a Shopify CSV to get your products imported quickly and effectively. What you're going to need today is you're going to need access to Google Docs, which if you have a Google account, you can easily access Google Docs by going to docs.google.com and starting a brand new clean spreadsheet. You're also going to need an Excel or a CSV file to start with some existing product data, which I have right here. And other than that, you're going to need to learn a little bit of formulas, how to use formulas within Google Docs. Now, this isn't anything super complicated. I'm going to show you a lot about this, and I'm going to guide you through it. Now, I also want to apologize off the bat for the audio quality on this video. It's not the greatest, but this is the best microphone I have at this time to work with. So, with that, let's get started. First thing you want to do is you want to be able to download a sample CSV file from the Shopify website. So, if you head to this link, you can simply download a simple product CSV file, which I'm going to do right now. I just simply save it to my desktop. And the file is right here. Okay. And what you're going to do next is in another tab, you're going to have a Google Spreadsheets open. And in this first sheet here, what I'm going to do is go File, and I'm going to import a file. And the first file I'm going to import is I'm just simply going to import the Excel file or the CSV file that has the product data within it. And just double click on that. Let it upload, and what I'm going to do is instead of creating a new spreadsheet, I'm just simply going to you can insert a new sheet, or you can I'm just going to replace the current sheet that I have right now because it's a blank sheet anyway, and I'm just going to let that do its import. And as soon as that's done, I'm going to go through some of the information that's imported here, and I'll explain a little bit about it. It's pretty basic stuff for the most part. Just want to show you, like right now we have, like, here's the product part number, here's the product name, here's the brand name, there's different variations. We have a little bit of extra data here as well. There's some page information and stuff like here, or our page titles and things like that. We have the body description, price, and we have some other data over this way, including some photo information. Now, you're going to do next is we need to import the CSV that we downloaded from Shopify. So if we go to import, and we're going to upload another file, and that's going to be selected. So we have the product template CSV that we got from Shopify, and we're going to upload that. And this time we're going to select insert new sheets. And we're just going to simply import data. Now, this is very simple, right? Shopify just gives you a very small CSV to work with, but the most important thing is row one. It's going to have the different, it's going to have the handle, the title, everything that you need to be able to get information into your Shopify store is up here. And I'm going to go through that with you. First thing I'm going to do, though, is I'm just going to delete these. This is example information. I'm just going to simply delete this information. I'll just simply cut that out, like so. Actually, I'll just hit my delete key. There we go. Very simple. And what we need to do now is we need to take a lot of the data that is over here on this sheet, sheet one. And actually, just for I'm just going to rename this really quick. So just for reference. So let's call this. Product_info. Yeah, let's just take out the capitals just to keep it nice and clean. And we have over here, this is called product template. Let's also rename that to Shopify info. So, with that, what we're going to do is let's start very simply with a product name. So, right here we have the product name. And what we want to do is we want to take all of this data. So we have a total of sort of two, and if we go down to the bottom of the spreadsheet here, we can see we're at number looks like 667. So we have a total of a lot of products. And what I want to do is I want to make sure that I transfer all this information over correctly. So the first formula you're going to use is, we're starting at B2. So the trick to making this quick and effective is I'm just going to use a simple formula that is available to anybody who uses Google Docs. There is a list of formulas at this link right here of all the different formulas you can use. I won't go into them because there's a lot of them, but the primary one we are going to use to get this data transferred over is called array formula. And if you want, you can just kind of type it in. You have to have an equal sign before it, and just simply click there. And up here, this is where we're going to type in our information. So our cell number is B2, right, which is where we're going to start. And what we need to do is just simply enter in. We're going to go, it's going to start at B2, and we're going to go colon, and then we're just going to put B, and that'll get all the different information that is in B. Okay, everything from the very top to the very bottom. So I'm just going to click enter, and it didn't work. That's because in order to make sure that this does work, right now the B2 to B is just pulling the information from this spreadsheet. I also need to make sure I let it know that I need the product info from this sheet rather than the current sheet. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to type in product underscore info and put an exclamation point. And then it's B2 to B, and then just simply click enter, and that's going to take a minute or two to populate, and there it is. Okay, so all this data right here, all this data is an exact match of what we have over here. Okay, you can see all the numbers line up, everything like that. Okay, so that's how we import our title. Okay, I'm going to import the body as well, and what we have here is this is column I, so we're going to go same formula, array formula, I2 colon I, just right over here. So equals array formula, and this time we're going to go product underscore info exclamation point I2 colon I and close bracket and click enter, and it's going to pull all that data right into this column right here. Vendor, we have some vendor information right here. New vendor here, we need industries LED, so this is column C. So we're going to use the same formula. Equals array formula. And we're going to go product info, exclamation, and I believe it was C2 colon C. Close bracket, enter. There we go. Everything's in there. So it's all going to be for this specific list of products. I mean, the vendor is all the same throughout all the products. So if you have different vendors or different things like that, of course it'll pull that data. You don't have to worry about that. One thing that I do want to specify though, and give you a little bit of a different formula for, is the handle. Now, within Shopify, the handle, you could also say it's the URL of the product. Now, all of these handles have to be unique, okay? It can't be exactly the same as, you know, like here we have the title, and you can see the title is the same on a couple of these things, although the product number will be different, although the part number will be different. That is something that we're going to look at in a little bit. Actually, what I'm going to do is instead, so we have the product name here, column B. We also have a variation name, column D. I'm actually going to change my array formula just to show you how you can do that. So instead of going B2 to B, I'm going to go D2 to D, just like that. And then all of a sudden, we have all this new data in there. It's just pulling it from the product info sheet. So this is a little bit better. This is something that I think we can definitely work with, mainly because everything here is a little bit, the names of the products are a little bit more unique, and on top of that, it looks like it has a part number there as well, so we can look at getting that part number in there as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back to the handle, we're going to go up all the way to the top, and we're going to enter another array formula, okay? But this is going to be a little bit different, because the way that Shopify works is that for the handle, again, it has to be unique, but it also has to be lowercase and dashes. So I'm going to give you a little bit more information on how you can enter that. So we're going to go array formula, just click there. Now what we need to do is we're going to pull the data from, again, this is going to be column D in our product info sheet, but for every space, what we need to do is we need to make sure that these spaces, instead of being spaces, are now dashes. On top of that, we also need to make sure that there's no capitals in any of the in any of the titles, like over here. So how we're going to do that is we already have our array formula. So we are going to start by entering a command of substitute. So, and of course, we're going to put that in brackets so that it knows to make sure that this is our formula. And we're going to start with our column, which is D2 colon D, right? And we're going to enter a simple comma after that. And then what we're going to do is we're going to substitute, we're going to substitute the spaces, and we're going to comma that, and then we're going to tell it by putting a double quote and then a dash there. So what this is doing is this is saying, okay, take D2 to D, which is this information right here, and find all the spaces within it, and then replace the spaces with a dash. And I'm just going to enter that, and here we go. So it looks like I entered the wrong information here. That should be D, it's reading C. Okay, so, oh, this is why. Because I forgot to put the, we're looking on the product info sheet. So once we enter that, hit enter, and there it is. So all this information is the same information from here. This is the variation name, right? And we're replacing the spaces with dashes. Don't worry, if you have a dash within that field, you can see there's three dashes right here. Shopify will automatically correct that. The same thing with this quote here. You can't have a quote in the product handle, but Shopify will automatically delete that. Now, so we have this, and we have all the dashes there. That's great. However, we still have some capitals here. Okay, so what we're going to do is we are going to tell the Google Doc that we want all this product info, all this information, we want that to be lowercase. So we start at the beginning of our substitute and we type lower and opening bracket, and then we just want this information right here. Close bracket. And just the product info, D2 to the end of D, and just make sure they know it's lowercase. So there we go. Alright, so now everything is lowercase. You don't have to worry about anything. Shopify will take care of the double quote and this sort of like triple dash here. And we'll reduce that to one dash. And this should make it so that everything has its own unique handle. If it doesn't have a unique handle, it may reject the item. It will still accept all the other items, but it's always good to make sure that, you know, you have a nice unique handle, right? So this way you can make sure that anything that you upload, you don't have to upload a second or third time. You can just make sure that it uploads it the first time. So let's move on. So we have here vendor and type. Now on our data sheet, we don't really have a type here, but we know it's all LED lighting. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to make a simple array formula equals. There it is. And I'm just going to see if I can just put in just simple LED light. So, close bracket. Now I'm going to put that in quotes as well, just so that it knows to put that in there. And let's click enter, and that's not going to work. Okay, that's not a problem. What we can do is instead of doing that, if we're just going to enter in manual like information like this, I'm just going to go up here and just go LED lighting. That's fine. And I'm going to take this, I'm going to hold shift key, and I'm also going to hold control, and I'm going to press straight down. And what that's going to do is it's going to give me every single cell. What I want to do actually is I only want to go to, let me just go back up, let's try a different method. So I'm going to hold my shift key, and I'm going to press page down until I get to the very bottom. So I have, I believe it's 600 and some odd products here. Yeah, it's 667. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hold my control key and press D. And that's just going to duplicate that information all the way down so that I don't have to worry about that. So again, if you're going to manually type things in, just simply, you know, highlight all the cells you want them to be in. Highlight the first cell, go all the way down, and just put, hold control and press D. That'll duplicate all that information there. Tags. Now, if you have a large store and you want to be able to search by tags, this is definitely important. We do have some tag information here. This is right here, and you can see it's all comma separated right up here. So this is column E, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that we grab all this information in column E. Now, if you have gaps in here, you may want to manually fill these in, or you may want to just come up with a quick system to just make sure that you can get some kind of information in here, so that you don't have to worry about this section being blank. But just for this video, what we're going to do is we're going to import all of column E using an array formula. So equals array formula, and we're going to use I think it's column E, E2 colon E. And just click enter, and of course that's going to enter it from the sheet. You need to make sure that when we're doing this, we specify the sheet product info exclamation point, and then that way it knows. Okay, so there's all the data, and you want to make sure that that transfers over. That's good. Now, published. Shopify wants to know whether this is a published product or whether this is just it's not. Whether or not it is published, whether it's going to be on the front end of your store or whether it's not going to be. This is just simply a true or false statement. So for this video, we're just going to put true, enter, and we're going to hold my shift key. I'm going to press page down until I get to the very bottom of all these products. And then once I'm here, I'm just going to hold down control and D. And that's going to clone it all the way down. And let's just go back to the top now. And option one name. So this is basically what it's asking for. Shopify is asking for whether or not you have options like variants within your products, and that's fine. There's a different way to upload that kind of information. However, just because for this video, all these products are unique. They all have their own individual part number and everything like that. So what we're going to do is we're just going to do the Shopify defaults for that. And if you ever want to look up this information, you can go to this link, and it's going to just give you some information on the product CSV file format. And it's going to just simply say, we're just going to leave this as, this is only going to have a single option, so we're going to just put this as title. And again, what we're going to do is we're going to hold shift, page down all the way to the bottom, or the end of our products, I should say. And we're just going to hold control D, clone that over, and go back to the top. And option one value is going to be default value. And again, if you want to make reference to this, this is over on the Shopify page. So you can see option one name, option one value. This is a product with only one single option. And we're just going to set this as a default title. So also default title. All right. And again, we're just going to just going to go here, and we're going to go all the way down to the end of our product list, and just control D. All right, and we're going to go to the top. We don't have any other options. You don't have to worry about that. Variant SKU. I'm hoping that a lot of your products have a different SKU, and this is available on the product info sheet under part number. So this is column A. So we're going to array formula that equals array formula. And product info exclamation point A2 colon A. And that's just going to pull all the part numbers in there. That's perfect. Variant in grams. Okay. One thing to note is that Shopify, when you're doing a product import via CSV, you have to make sure that the weight of your product is in grams rather than pounds or kilograms or anything like that. And you can do that just through a simple calculation. I think on this sheet you don't have any listed weight for these products. So yeah, it looks like weight is pretty much zero all the way down. Yeah, there's no listed weight, but most of the time, especially if you're shipping out physical products, you're going to have a weight for your product. So what you want to do is you just want to simply get a converter. The easiest way I do that is I just do a Google search and say pounds to grams, okay, and just simply, you know, be able to put a mathematical formula in there. So if you do have data, you just simply call the data and then you multiply it by, you know, or divide it by whatever information is available here, right? So let me just show you what that would look like. So let's say column S right here. So we go over here, and now these are all just going to be zero, but it's going to go, we're going to go like this. We're going to go equals product, oh sorry, equals array formula, and we're going to start with product info exclamation point S2 colon S, oops, S, and we're going to multiply that by so 1 pound equals 453.592 grams, so we're going to multiply that by 453.592. Yeah, okay. And let's just simply go close bracket on that. And of course everything's going to equal zero. You multiply everything by zero, it equals out to zero. So if you have a, let's just for example, let's take the A2, and let's just say the weight is one, right? And that could be a pound, that could be whatever unit it's weighed in, and then go back to your shipping info, and there it is, right? 453.592, right? So it will automatically convert your weight, if this is in pounds, to grams, and this is how much it would weigh, and then Shopify will convert that back. It just wants a general starting point, and grams was their starting point for how they would measure the weight. So variant inventory. So interesting thing about this is that when you have your variant inventory, this is something that can be left blank. If you want to track your inventory, you can put different information in there. The inventory quantity you have to put into one. So we can leave this variant inventory, hang on, variant inventory tracker, and then variant inventory quantity. You always want to put one in here. So just simply go one, and then we're just going to highlight all the way down the page to the end of our product list. Oops. And that, that array formula has gone off a little bit, but that's something we can fix in a moment. And of course, we want a D. Do that. All right, and let's go to the top again. Variant inventory policy. So what Shopify wants to know with the inventory policy is how to handle orders if the inventory goes below zero. If you're doing drop shipping, or if you're working with a supplier, or you don't have your own inventory, you can just simply put continue, and then that way it'll keep selling and selling and selling. Or if you have your own inventory, you can just simply put deny. So for this, we're going to put continue because this is more of a drop shipping model. So inventory policy, continue. And we're just going to, again, we're going to go all the way down to the end of our product list. Oops. Just like that. And we're going to control D, copy that all over, and move it to the top of the page. Variant fulfillment. So it wants to know what who's going to be fulfilling this. And what we want to enter for this is we just want to enter in manual for this, because this is going to be something that this is going to be drop ship. If you have your own different way of shipping things, you can definitely look up more information on that, but for this video we're just going to simply put it in manual, and we're going to copy that all the way down our proc list one more time. Control D, and we're back to the top. Okay, variant price. This is something that's listed on our product info sheet. So we have retail price and we have sale price. So what we have on the Shopify sheet is we have the variant price and the variant compare at price. So this would be variant price would be sale price, and compare at price would be the regular price that you might look at. So the sale price we want to enter in here. This is what the customer will buy it at. So this is column K. So let me just enter a simple array formula. Equals array formula. So we're going to go K2 colon K and bracket. Oops. Okay, hold shift and then press 2. And give it a moment. Oh, that's why. We got to enter product info again. So there it is, okay. And what we're going to do is for the compare at price, we're going to get the retail price. So that's column J. So equals array formula product underscore J2 colon J. All right, looks good. And there we go, that information is populated. Variant requires shipping. This is probably, if you're selling physical products, yeah, you're probably going to want to put this to, oops, you're going to want to put this to true. Okay, variant requires shipping, yeah, you want to just make this sure this is true or false. And so what we're going to do is we're going to go in here, capital letters type true, and go all the way down to the bottom of our product list. And D, put that in there, back up to the top. Taxable, we want to know if it's going to be something that Shopify is automatically going to add taxes to. I believe this is a true or false statement as well. Yep, so if you're going to be charging taxes on this within your state or within your country or province or wherever, just simply put true. If you're not, then it's going to be false. Variant barcode. If you have a barcode for this, you can enter it here. We don't have a barcode for this, so we're just going to leave that blank. Image source. So on this, we do have an image source. Oops. We do have an image source in the product info spreadsheet, and that's over here, photo, and that's going to be just column AA. Now, on this, of course, this is just this has to be a URL. It has to be able to pull some data from somewhere. So maybe you might want to prefix this with something like, you know, your own website or wherever the information, wherever the photo is hosted. So I'm just going to enter the information as it is in the spreadsheet, in the Excel sheet. If the spreadsheet that you get doesn't have, you know, like an HTTP or an HTTPS in front of it, then you might have to enter that information manually. That's not a problem. I'll actually give you a quick example how to do that, just so we can do this. So what we're going to do is we're going to simply go equals array formula, open bracket, and we're going to put my website. So jz.com/, and then we're going to use an and statement. So when you use this and right here, this is just a simple and symbol, it's going to connect something to it. So we're going to go create formula. This is going to start with this, jameso.com/, and then we're going to pull the data from product info, the product info sheet, starting with AA2:AA, close bracket. And what it's going to do is it's going to start it with jameso.com/, and then it's going to have the product images or the information from the the Excel sheet over here. It's going to pull all that data over onto the sheet. So there's no information here. This is just something I entered just at random, and I actually didn't even put the two slashes there. So that's fine. Image position. For this specific template, everything's going to be one. But if you had multiple images for the same product, there is a way to enter that, and then you just simply enter the image position in here so that, you know, this would be your first image, and then you would have second, third, fourth, fifth, and I'm not going to go into that information on how to do that here. This is just for single products, one on every line. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to copy that all the way down. Oops. And you can see, yeah, it's just going off a little bit there. That's fine. And we're just going to simply control D that over so that I go in. And image alt text. So if you want some image alt text, you can put that in here. I recommend that for SEO. It can be left blank over here. You don't have to fill out that information, but I do recommend it if you want some good SEO. Now what it's asking for is this a gift card? And as you can see over here, it needs to be true or false. For this purpose, it's a product, this is not a gift card, so we're going to put false. And we're going to go all the way down again, down the product list. And we're just going to simply go clone that over. And the rest of this information is all from there's Google Shopping. If you're hooked up with Google Shopping, you would enter some information here. There's also SEO title and SEO description. The SEO title, if you don't put an SEO title in there, it will simply use whatever is in the title section. So this will be your SEO title. We're going to overlook that section for now. But if you do have a different SEO title that you want for your products, you would enter it there. Same thing with SEO description. And then there's more columns for Google Shopping, just to enter information there. Variant image. The variant image is just for if you're using variants, and if you have a different image that you want to use for specific products, you can put it in here. Variant weight in units. So, or variant weight unit. So, if you want your units to display, or the weight to display in pounds or kilograms, you enter that here. I'm just going to go LB for pounds, and I'm just going to copy that again all the way down the item list. Yes, it's right there. And we're just going to simply duplicate that down, go back up to the top. Variant tax code, I believe this is just simply used for if you have a different tax code, and that's only in Shopify Plus. So you can enter that information here if that is available to you. All right, once we have all this information in place, all you need to do in order to make sure that this is going to be something that you can import to Shopify is, within Google Docs, it will automatically save this. You can see all changes are saved. So this is automatically saved within your Drive folder. You just simply need to go File and Download as comma separated values. And from here, you can save this to wherever you'd like on your computer. Give it a quick name, shopifyinfo.csv. We'll save that to desktop. And here it is, right here. And from here, all you need to do is just simply go to your Shopify store and go to the import function, and I'll just show you where that would be. So if we go here and log in, and you simply go products, and go import, and choose a file right here, and oops, hang on, it's uploading. Oh, there we go. So. Upload, and it will take some time to process that, and then it will give you some information regarding this. You know, it'll just ask you, you know, okay, is this information correct? Is this, and it'll give you a rough summary of how many products they're going to upload. This is an approximation, okay? This is an exact number, but it will just let you know exactly what information Shopify is receiving and give you a quick summary of it. And if you want to edit that information, you can just simply click this link right here. and then you can actually change, you know, like, okay, if this is the product title, okay, if this is the product description, but maybe it's not, maybe there's some different information, you can just simply change that by a toggle and go from there. If you have any more questions, just let me know, maybe in a comment or in just you contact me, just simply shoot me an email or you can go from there. Thank you very much, and you have fun.